this morning preparing for the service, I had this deep sense of how each one of us is known by God, is known on the inside as we pray in the quiet for purity, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid. And so we come here this morning in that knowledge, that as we come into God's house and come together to praise this wonderful God, that we are deeply known by God, and that God seeks to meet us in that knowing. We read in the Gospel this morning that the 10 men with leprosy don't say to Jesus, "Heal us of our leprosy." The King James Version says it so beautiful. They say, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." And in doing so, they are opening themselves to the understanding that God knows exactly what we need. That when we come to God in the depth of our vulnerability and we seek God's mercy, God's grace, God's love, God's faithfulness, God will meet us often in a place that is deeper than we even understand that we need to be. And so I'm so blessed that this morning each one of us has come here from whatever it is that we are experiencing in life. Come here with that cry in our hearts to say, "Lord Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." And we read in the Gospel how Jesus says to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests," and as they walk, they are cleansed. In the time of that setting, you would have to go to the priest to be declared clean again from leprosy before you'd be able to engage. And so Jesus tells them, "Go in faith, walk, and go to the priest and show yourselves, and be reunited in your community." And we read that as they go, they are made whole, and or they are cleansed. And this for me is an amazing thing. You know, they have so much faith. Jesus doesn't lay hands on them. He's not dramatic. He doesn't do something incredible. There's no lightning. There's no thunder. He just gives them a command: "Go and show yourselves to the priest." And as they do that very simple act, they are cleansed from the leprosy. And then it's really interesting to me because the one turns back and comes to praise God, to say, "Thank you, Lord, that you have cleansed me." And he receives something even deeper. Jesus says, "You have been made whole." And in that moment, we see something very mysterious unfolding. That one, we have to ask. We have to come to God in the point of our needs. We have to be willing to be vulnerable. And two, we have to trust that what God tells us to do is real and true and will work for us. And then thirdly, when we are grateful for that, we receive even more than we could even ask or think or imagine. And so we come here this morning just being reassured with that knowledge. And we see from the story of Naaman, you know, Naaman goes to be healed of his leprosy. He takes all his chariots and his horses. He's a very great man. And he comes and he says to Elisha, "I've come to be healed." Elisha doesn't even come out to see him. Elisha is not impressed by all those things. And the man is angry. He's like, "You're telling me to go and simply wash in a river that is dirtier than the one that I know?" And he throws a tantrum. And it's his slaves who tell him, "But Father told you to do something dramatic. Would you not have done it? Why not do something as simple as follow that instruction and wash the tables?" And so he goes, he does it, that simple thing. And when he comes back praising God, saying, "There is no God but the one God in Israel." was rich or because he could pay him. God helped him because God wanted to help him. And in the same way for all of us here now, we all have free access to that healing that each one of us needs deep on the inside of us. And we're reminded this morning by Paul that even if we are chained, God's word is not chained. That the word of God can set us free. And so we come to the service we have here as a community of the faithful. We stand here in the gap for all those people that we know and love who are suffering and struggling. We stand here in the gap for our nation, which is suffering and struggling. And we come to God in that hopefulness, that expectation, to know that God seeks us, God wants us, God will heal us. And it is for us to just leave with a grateful heart. I want to end with something that I had on my status, my profile pic, as a, for quite a while. People that know me well know that I love butterflies. And the reason for that is that my name means resurrection. And in the Christian tradition, the butterfly is a symbol of resurrection. And the profile pic I had was the butterfly is only beautiful because the caterpillar is brave. The butterfly is only beautiful because the caterpillar is brave. And so, as we go into this week, let us allow the caterpillar in our lives to be cocooned in God's love and God's grace and God's mercy. And let us cocoon other people in God's love